What's up, everybody? We're back again for another episode of Table Talks. It's a beautiful day, so we decided, let's be outside, get some of that fresh air, some of that vitamin D.
Come on.
Vitamin D?
I think so.
Vitamin D, right? Got the right vitamins. This is another episode, but today we're doing leadership like we do every single Saturday. And so, man, tomorrow's Sunday, which means it's going to be awesome.
Come on.
And trust me, you're not going to miss tomorrow. It's going to best Sunday service we've ever done yet. It's going to be good. Best. All right, Tyler, what are we talking about today? Real quick, in leadership, let's knock it out real quick in a few minutes.
Today we're talking about being solution-oriented. As leaders, we run into a lot of problems. I don't have to tell you guys that. You know that. We run into a lot of problems, but it's really important to be solution-oriented. Yep. Just to kick it off, why is that important?
Everybody can be problem-oriented. That's the key right there. Like, anybody can spot a problem. Like, I don't like that. That ain't working. That's the easy job. The hard job is to see what's not working and then want to bring a solution to it, right? And to see what's not working and not complain, but be solvent, right? Like, I'm going to bring a solution to it. And it's easy to get on that Facebook, get on the Twitter, be like, nah, 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 nah. Like, we don't need that. What we need is progression, right? Yeah. That's what we're called to as leaders. So let's be solvers, not complainers.
Yeah. So I've heard it said you can solve it quick or you can solve it right. Mm-hmm. What do you think about that?
I actually think you got to do them both.
Yeah.
Well, and you might say, well, how do you do both? That's like an easy way out. But I feel like today, with times changing so fast, right, you got to be quick to change and you got to be quick to adapt, right?
Yeah.
And to do it right means if it's not working, stop it and move on, right? Don't be scared of change. Don't think that, oh my gosh, I can't look like I'm wrong. Suck up your pride and be healthy and right over being right or wrong, right? And so we're always, every single week, we're tweaking. We are changing. We're re-looking at the format we're doing because we're in a time right now no one's ever done this.
Yeah.
No one's ever been in our history, right, in our lifetime, where there has been no way to meet in large gatherings. So every week we're looking at it and going, okay, we need to fix this. We need to change this, tweak this. And I'm okay starting something and stopping something if it's not working because that's the right decision.
Yeah.
The right decision is going towards health, even if you have to kill some things that aren't working.
Yeah, that's so good. So in leading, if you're leading teams, you obviously will run into problems. Mm-hmm. They will obviously run into problems.
Mm-hmm.
At what responsibility level do you take your staff's problems?
Well, what I want for my staff is this. I have no issue with failure. I have no issue with problems. What I do have an issue with is problems and failures without some ideas attached to them.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
So here's what my goal is for my staff and my issue. Is I want to hear your problems, but I also want to hear 3 to 5 solutions brought to that problem, right?
Yeah.
And what do you mean 3 to 5? Because normally your first idea is not the best idea. And a lot of times we'll go off our first idea because that's in our opinion, right? But if I hear 3 to 5, we're going to find the best idea to get moving forward, right?
Yeah.
So I like for multiple ideas to come together so then we can hash it out together and go, okay, right, we're making the right decision quickly, not just making whatever's our opinion what's going to be our concrete solution.
Yeah.
So we're trying to get that right in that mindset.
Yeah, I think that's really important, like in creating a culture of problem solvers instead of what you called them earlier, problem dwellers.
Yes.
So real quick in closing, talk to the leader who either might be a problem dweller or has some team members that are a problem dweller. What do they need to do to kind of move that needle?
Number one, if you find yourself complaining, you're not solving anything.
Yeah.
So take a check of your heart and take a check of your speech. So look at that. Number two, you've got to start setting the expectation. You got to say, number one, I don't want to find out my problems from someone else.
Yeah.
I need you to always come to me. And number two, I always want 3 to 5 ideas to go with them. When you're setting those expectations very clearly with your team, you will start seeing deliverable results towards movement and progression. This is not the end. Your situations and circumstances are not the end. You're going to face them, but we can solve them. We can move beyond, and we can grow together. Guys, like I said earlier, tomorrow's going to be amazing.
Yeah.
It's the best Sunday experience we've ever done. Like I said, every week we're tweaking it and we're doing a little bit more. It's going to be awesome. Hopefully you enjoyed Table Talk today, leadership. Every week we drop in some different topics 6 days a week. Until then, pray God's peace.